concept across, I threw some examples together. Again, what Cortex does, it's a software platform. You can log in. It's really easy. You can point it at your entire industry, or just looking at a tight set of competitors, or just yourself. So you can learn based on all those different groups. You can slice by geography, right? I only want to sell this region at the moment or something. And that content, you know, the tastes of that audience will be different. Right. So getting the insights is important. So as you can see here, the way you kind of read this is Cortex finds all these combinations and insights for you once you've pointed it at something like we just talked about. So in this case, we were looking at the entire coffee industry for one of our customers. And if you look at the coffee industry, one of the trends that Cortex finds by itself automatically is something like this, that's showing specifically coffee mugs at a downward angle, right? So the camera is kind of above the coffee mug in some capacity. It decreases engagement by 14%, right? So that's one discrete insight. And using Cortex doing an analysis, you'll get dozens or hundreds of these. But so just to talk about what you were talking about, this is kind of exactly, I think, a really good example of like, you know, okay, so you're trying to sell coffee online. One of the questions you probably have is, do I show beans or do I show mugs, right? One question is, if I show mugs, do I show it, you know, how do I shoot the mug, right? Or do I show people having a great time, or do I show the product, right? There's all these different questions that you probably or at least should be thinking about. And as you can see, just there's huge differences just by, you know, putting the camera in a certain position or choosing mug over cup or mug over beans or something like that. And that's, of course, below the median. That's like, you know, negative impact against kind of the average piece of content. So that means actually there'll be some insights above the median that might have 10 or 20 or 50% lift. And then if you look at the delta, you know, say, well, before I was choosing this one, mugs at a downward angle, and now I can be choosing these other things, you know, that's a 70% lift just by making that one change. And of course, you can do this data not just on, you know, where the camera is, but also the colors in the image. One thing I pulled out right getting before here was in that same industry in coffee, this exact color, this exact hex code here, fire brick, you know, kind of red, does 8% lift over the median compared to a slightly darker red here was -2%, right? And so even though those two colors look very, very close, right? To me, I'm like mildly colorblind actually. So they actually look quite close to me.
I'm colorblind also. I'm right there with you.
Good. Yeah, I was gonna say this one's a little bit darker, I think, from what people tell me. But that's a 10% delta, right? Just by changing the color saturation and the colors you use, right? So whether that's changing your product or changing the background, or in this case, changing the donut color, you know, changing the background behind the text and this Happy Thanksgiving message. And so all of those choices, whether it's how we crop the image, whether it's the colors, whether it's where's the camera, whether it's what's in the image, all of those things contribute, of course, to the conversion rates. And getting those right is really important.
What I find fascinating, it's going to find correlations between all this and like that normal people won't be able to see, like the difference between fire brick red and normal red. Like you, like the normal human won't know. Like the normal human eye won't know the difference, but there are certain subconscious factors when making this content that are going to make a big difference, and that could really like make a big difference on the way you design your content that your AI will be able to see that the human eye won't.